Namaste. Welcome back. We are currently doing module 2 and this is lecture number 15, the last in the series for this VTU Shikshana program. Module 2, specialized air conditioning systems and as per the NBC 2016. We will continue. Last class in the same category, we have seen the healthcare facilities, if you remember. So let us see the next one, that is server rooms and data centers. Alright, so what are the HVAC considerations for designing HVAC for server rooms and the data center? Now, data centers we all might have come across at some point. They deal with a lot of equipment. Handling the computer system, the automation system, the grids, motherboards, right? So that is the one, and people are not so crucial here. It is not comfort AC, it is a process AC. Occupant load in data centers is nearly 1 to 2% of the total load. Rest is primarily server or equipment load. So the occupant load is user. So people comfort is not the primary objective here, but taking care of the server and the equipment related loads is the objective. Therefore, in this type of building, the majority of load would be sensible heat load, right? So latent heat load was when the temperature along with the air with water vapor was considered. That is when we take care of occupancy loads where people perspire, give out water vapor, etc. So here it's basically sensible heat load calculation only, majorly. Critical to maintain the operating conditions of the server room and the equipment for their safe and consistent operation and output at lowest operating cost. That is the intent of a HVAC system, right? So we have to maintain the server room equipment which are running continuously, generating lot of heat. So we have to maintain the indoor environment such that they will function properly, all the equipment, all the appliances, at lowest operating cost. The design needs should be identified after working closely with the architect, equipment, server manufacturer and the HVAC consultant. So you see so many players here to design a HVAC system. So architect will lead the role in assembling the other consultants or required personnel and deliberating on what would be the best design layout. Data center is a technological facility which houses electronic equipment used for data processing, storing and networking. So these are commonly called as data comm equipment and they will look somewhat like that. The design requirement for cooling of such a technological facility differs significantly from the comfort air conditions that we have seen. So designing for homes, designing for hotels, designing for theaters, different because their comfort AC is the objective, people-based comfort levels, here not so. Major contributing heat is from the electronic equipment which is sensible heat in nature. Hence, cooling equipment needs to be designed with a high sensible factor correlating to the sensible heat gain. Main focus is equipment cooling rather than comfort conditions for the space or people. And it is 24/7 running. There is never a stop or closure of the data center ever. So that is the criticality. High reliability and redundancy is an important criteria as any loss of data from the server may contribute to huge financial losses. We all know that how much we panic when the server is down, even for some time. or if the PC hangs. So all interconnected, especially when the network cables are off, when the Wi-Fi is not working, there is almost panic. So data loss is a huge crisis these days. The need is to be highly reliable besides being energy efficient, both. So NPC offers the standards or present recommended range for temperature and moisture is given that we can look at. These are the indoor thermal conditions advised in the NBC. So low end 18 degree, high end 27. Moisture is also given there, 60% RH. So that is a brief and the intent by which we have to design our server room HVAC systems. So the main objective was sensible heat gain and likewise addressing the cooling loads. Next, very quickly at the theaters and the considerations. We all know theaters are spaces of large gathering spaces with many people at a given point of time. So, and spatially or volume wise also they are large in size. High ceiling, definitely. Low external load, high occupancy load, producing a high latent gain. So it is opposite to what we saw sensible gain there, here it is latent gain. And low sensible heat factor. So these considering, we have to design a suitable HVAC system. Large fresh air quantities are needed and the operating noise levels also have to be controlled, subdued or minimized. Theater and auditorium may be in use only a few hours a day whenever the event is held. So what happens during the non-working hours, how do we shut off the valve, all that has to be in place in the HVAC design. Movie theater design considerations shall be based upon timing of usage when the movie runs, post and prior to the movie beginning, low occupancy levels at non-movie times, and low sensible load. Care has to be taken to ensure proper relative humidity levels without overcooling the space. Now, nobody comes dressed in coat or jerkins or thermals. So we can't make it either too cold also. System design shall meet the required noise criteria. Noise levels have to be minimal. The lobby and exit passageways in a multiplex, which are seldom densely occupied, can be expected for short. So these kind of lobbies and passageways can be zoned as a single zone with a similar requirement. So we can revisit the concept of zoning in HVAC, where we group spaces of similar expectation of cooling load based on the heat generated and occupancy levels as zone 1, 2, 3, 4 and so forth. So we can group these kind of spaces together and they can be designed with the separate set of parameters. Now moving on to the last category that we will study in this lecture, the hotel guest rooms and the considerations regarding HVAC design. All right. So all of us have at some point of time stayed at a hotel guest room and we know how it functions. Each room is a separate entity and it's a world for the user there, and the number of hours the visitor actually spends in the room is much less. Probably it's only overnight stay, and the daytime the visitor has other things to do. Now each guest room or each zone could be a group of guest rooms with similar HVAC calibrations. Now each guest room or each zone shall be provided with not less than one thermostat capable of being set between 15 degree to 30 degrees and capable of operating the system with respect to cooling and heating. So that is a thermostat which is normally located on the wall. User interface is easy, up to say 1200 from the floor level. And that's a typical room, essentially with bed, single, double, and the required ancillary furniture. Balcony also. So the thermostat or control system or both shall have an adjustable headband, the range of which includes a setting of 12 degrees Celsius between cooling and heating, where automatic changeover is provided. So setting the system for automatic sensing via the thermostat and self-adaptation is advisable. Wall-mounted temperature control shall be mounted preferably on an inside wall of the room. The room may be unoccupied for most of the day, and therefore provision for operating at reduced capacity or switching off when not in use for a certain period of time is essential. Calibrating it for such a shutdown or going down to the reduced capacity. Low operating noise levels are recommended. Reliability and ease of maintenance essential, prerogative. The fan coil unit, to recollect, it is that small cabinet enclosed factory assembled, which has the evaporator coil, filters, fan motor embedded. It is the smallest version of the air handling unit. It is generally found to be the most suitable for its kind of application. So generally speaking, hotel guest rooms have a fan coil unit placed within them. With speed control for the fan and motorized modulating valve for chilled water control for cooling. So the condenser compressor will be a single plant out of which many evaporators will branch out, and they can be used comfortably with localized conditioning parameters. So to the right we see a VRF, variable refrigerant flow airflow system, fan coil unit which is placed on the ceiling, the various lines, and this will be embedded in the false ceiling. Access panel, refrigerant lines, air duct, supply grills, the blue line, blue arrows, red arrows, return air grill, sucking in the used air. Alright, so that is what we will now end the session with a quick exercise. If you can explore a HVAC AC design for following types of buildings, departmental store, educational institutions, and most recently, or most currently, COVID-19 related paradigm shift in hospital HVAC systems. Alright, so we have seen four categories of specialized AC in this lecture series: healthcare, server room, theaters, and considerations for hotel guest rooms. So accordingly, you can increase your spectrum of understanding by looking at departmental store, educational institutions, and many more actually. And you can refer National Building Code for the same and ASHRAE standards, ASHRAE or ISHRAE. So that ends our, this is a concluding session for modules 1 and 2 for this term. We completed mechanical ventilation and air conditioning systems, and I really hope you were enjoying these sessions and understanding the components in the syllabus framework. I really hope so, and you continue the learning process ahead. Refer to the references given in between and the links for videos shared to get a better grasp on things. Alright. So I wish you all the very best and a bright future ahead, a wonderful upcoming seventh semester for you people, for all of you out there. Thank you very much. So I, Dr. Dakshani R. Patil, sign off from this VTU eShikshana program. Have a nice, safe future ahead. Take care.